Hi, my name is Nova. I'm Nova Nelson. I'm from Cultivate Central. Just a little bit about myself, as they pull up the slides, but it's not about my presentation. I live in Singapore right now. I'm Malaysian living in Singapore right now. But I do work with regards to urban gardening, growing food, roadside, other crossbreed. And what Cultivate Central is really about, we really want to bring food sources closer to where we live. And weaving edible spaces within the urban context. So rethinking space and how space is used in the urban context, see, hey, why is it edible? And realizing that more and more of us, as populations increase in the city, more and more of us are also living in smaller spaces. So then the question is, how do we grow food in smaller spaces? So these are the three things that I'm very interested in looking at. About a couple of years back, I was producing a radio documentary called Here and Now in Malaysia. And we kept going back to agriculture as a topic. Documentary airs on the FM in 1999. And you can't see the picture, but nice paddy farmer we met up in Penang. In Malaysia, the average age of our paddy farmer is 60 years old. And the average age of our vegetable farmer is about 56, 58 years old. So, you know, who's going to be farming for us? Who's going to be providing? Who's going to be doing the work that they're currently doing? So that was a real question that struck me when I did that program. So maybe later we can talk about, you know, who farms, who grows food, and it's a very important question, I think. And currently, what we do at Cultivate is really work with communities and collaborations. So in Penang, for instance, there is a project called Think Green. It's actually a private sector led project. It's in a public park and it's educational. We teach our children how to grow their own food. But we work with people like Consumer Association Penang, other urban farmers in Penang that's been doing it for years. And that has become a big thing for us to concentrate on building communities and collaborations within the scheme and within the efforts of growing food. And as we, I think we'll talk about this a bit more later, do we have the space to grow food in cities? I think a lot of people ask me, how do we get the scale? Do we have the space? Where we can grow? I live in an apartment, live in a box. Yeah. Okay, but actually if you look around, and I think again we'll talk about this more, like there, many of us here are growing food in small spaces. There is space, and it's just about identifying and being creative about the space. So this, you can't see it now, but maybe we can share the pictures later on or something. These pictures, it's actually an urban farm in Penang as well. It used to be a car park behind an old, it's the Consumer Association Penang office, it's a bus road. And behind that office used to be a car park. We turned the car park into an urban farm. And it's educational. If you're in Penang, I would really recommend you visit it. They're really open and inspiring. When we talk about space, these are just examples again. In Singapore, where people think there's not a lot of space, there's this place in Sembawang in Singapore where it's just like a little home for food. You go in and you can rent plot, and maybe a plot is as long as this building, maybe this width, and there's a community of growers there, and they all, you know, they haven't bought their vegetables from the market for years, 6-7 years, they've been growing their own food, and they share their food, and they share stories about what vegetable worked today, and didn't work, and you know, share seeds, and it's lovely, and maybe something like that could be considered in a place like KL. It doesn't take much space, it's happening in a place that like Singapore. And they get really creative, and it's like little homes, they spend lots of hours there. So the question about space again, you know, you can do it, like the model could be in a park where it's shared, the model could be I rent a plot, and this doesn't have any food yet, but Next week there will be some food, because this will be a space we're converting next week onwards. It's actually on the rooftop in an old heritage building, and it's a shared office space. There's a cafe downstairs, and we'll turn this into a small little food garden. It's